Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Middle East for the ongoing Eldorado series. We've got a triple header this afternoon. I honestly built, see, this person is familiar with the ground rules, clapping at every slight nuance or suggestion. Beautiful. All right, free drink. Anyway, so we have a beautiful triple header here, and starting it off from New Zealand, from New York, from down the street, Galaxie 500. Let's have a big Middle East welcome.
Came to the car, but she wouldn't save me. executive the other night said that our song's going for too long, so that was for him. This is Jonathan Richman's song. Crashing really badly, or about a gig we did at the Middle East Cafe, I'm deciding. But we haven't actually rehearsed it with the lyrics, so. I think I can see them from here.
faster than this galaxy phone. I don't know if that's loud enough already, but anyway.
Thank you.
we're gonna do a couple of new songs. So it's called When Will You Come Home?
Thank you. Thank you. I feel like Rod Stewart is inside me tonight. I feel like Rod Stewart is inside me tonight. Because my voice is like going. So forgive me on the high notes. Sick.
Turn off the spot.
It glows, eh?
Yes.
Check it out.
Thank you. For $10, they glow. That's beautiful. That's perfect.
Silence, even though it's a blessing. delicious, delicious. And you know just what to do. Thank you.
is getting late, and we're going very fast because we're not having any technical problems. It's very strange.
Thank you.
you.
I'm not afraid to die.
You're over on tour here in the UK at this moment in time, yeah?
We're on a... Well, we're supporting another band this Sunday. It's a mini tour, and we were over here about a month ago touring for 6 weeks, so we've been back and forth a lot.
You're back and forth to Europe a lot. Basically, the response in Europe has been really good, critically, yeah? To your records?
Yeah. We seem to get nice reviews everywhere. In the States, too.
Yeah. Do you find it different over here in the sense of audience spaces and critics and to America?
We haven't been down to MTV in America yet, which might give you an idea. That's not an audience thing, I guess, but...
No. You don't find any difference, though?
Well, no, we do. The food is better, especially here in England.
Wait a minute.
We're bigger in England, I guess.
You like fish and chips.
Is that a crime to like fish and chips?
No.
The continent's very different. The clubs are run differently. They're run by kids.
Right.
Yeah, a lot of times they're run communally.
They're run for the bands. They treat the bands nicely.
Yeah.
In America, it's like some fat old guy with a cigar, like, saying he won't pay you at the end of the night. It's like a typical experience.
Okay. The descriptions of your music range really everywhere from sort of fragile to floating, all the way across the sort of spectrum to wimpy at the worst end of it. What is the actual aim in the sense of when you're making your records? What kind of atmospheres are you looking for?
Wimpiness.
Two parts wimpy, one part atmospheric, one...
Fragility.
A little dash of pastoral imagery.
Yeah.
All that crap.
Yeah.
It's a formula. We found it in a book, actually.
You found it where, sorry?
In a book.
Right.
How to succeed in the music business.
How to sell a couple of thousand records.
Be a wimp.
But not more than that.
Gotcha. There's always as well references, particularly from the British press, to television, Velvet Underground and things like that. Is that a problem for you?
I don't think it's a problem.
No, it's flattering.
Yeah.
All bands we like.
Yeah. What is it with the sort of East Coast bands, in the sense of, particularly in the sort of mid-80s through till now, a lot of sort of rootsy sort of guitar, cerebral sort of arty kind of head. What is it? Is it in the water in New York or Boston or what?
The rootsy stuff is in the water in Boston, but we kind of steer away from that, I don't think.
Yeah.
But like a roots band. There's a lot of that in Boston, though. In New York, is there a rootsy thing? If there is, people don't pay attention to it. It's over on like the west side of Bleecker Street, away from CBGBs. Yeah.
The further
east you go in Manhattan can be broken down into various musical groupings.
Right.
The further east you go, the more...
the fewer blues progressions.
Right.
Yeah.
The more strangely tuned guitars and syringes, stuff like that.
Except for Noise New York.
Separate Noise New York,
which is on the west side. That's why it's an exception, an outpost.
That's where we record.
Yeah, you recorded. This is your second album, which has just come out in the UK. You record very quickly, I understand.
That's right. We record all the rhythm tracks first take. Almost everything on our records first take.
So, how long do you actually spend in putting your records together?
A couple days.
Well, and actually recording, it really only takes a week or two, but. It takes us a long time to, because we're recording so quickly, it takes us a long time to prepare before that.
Yeah.
We record so quickly partially because our producer, Kramer, records quickly. So we finish playing the rhythm tracks of the song and there's a silence and we wait and then we hear, next, over the microphone. So.
And we have no desire to go out into the country and spend 2 months sitting around going, blunk, 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 blunk.
Creating drum sounds.
Yeah. And what's the point?
Yeah.
We record very live and that's the way we like it. With all the mistakes in there too.
Yeah. In the sense of the atmosphere. Do you sort of in that way it's very much a traditionalist form of music, a sort of an approach to music which is very much a 60s thing, which I know you sort of refer to with your album title today as celebrating that, but obviously doing your version of. Do you have in the sense of your own plan and head on where you're taking the group, a desire to stay away from the mainstream of what is rock music, popular
music?
Well,
we don't have a desire to move towards it. We'll just record the way that we have been recording, I think.
In the sense of the band's attitude, though, when I say mainstream, I don't just mean AOR rock. I mean the industry generally, music industry. Is it a game you want to play with or stay away from?
Well, you just want to try and let people let you do what you want to do. I guess, and I think there's maybe some room for common ground. So far there has been anyway. We're pretty happy right now with the label we're on.
but we aren't an indie label, and that suits us fine. Yeah. Rough Trade's a terrific label.
Yeah. That's an area you'd like to stay with, you think?
Sure.
I mean, because they've let us do what we want to do. I mean, from all aspects of the album. And
they let us rock. They let us bring the strippers on stage.
Yeah. They let us play the stadium shows if we want to.
With the kazoo.
They're not holding us back.
With the kazoo.
The kazoos. The kazoo chorus.
Mm-hmm. The women girls kazoo, with the kazoos.
The backup women kazoo chorus.
The whole thing.
Yeah.
Is there any particular other bands you feel an affinity with, contemporary wise?
That are playing right now? Sure. Yeah. Some.
The Spaceman 3. Dig their stuff.
Yeah. Some American bands, Yellow Tango.
Yeah.
Opal. They're not really playing anymore, though.
They're nuts.
Beatles, are they still around?
Three of them are still around.
In the sense of your influences, then, are you drawing, apart from the music side of things, are there any other things which influence you?
Influence the actual sound, attitude, the way you are?
Attitude.
All
kinds of things,
attitude.
I guess. We don't have enough attitude, I think. That's a problem.
Yeah. We've been discussing. We're working on the attitude.
Yeah, we've been sitting down with the record company and kind of talking about this.
You need look at the Stone Roses, an obvious publicity ploy, going out pouring paint on some poor guy.
Now they're going to come pour
paint. Now they're arrested. We want to be arrested. We can't get arrested, damn it.
Yeah.
Yeah. But maybe the wimpy image is the anti-image, which is going to be your strength, do you think?
He's got it. That's it.
Let's end the interview quick.
We got to work out our new wimpy approach to the interview.
Right.
Oh, I don't know.
Okay, I think that's fine.
All right.
Thank you.
We're done. The last guy that said that to me.